By the end of this tutorial, you will learn how to perform web scraping using AI agents and large language models. This is going to be a very detailed tutorial, so there is nothing to worry about. At the end, I will share the code and every file we use in this tutorial with you on my GitHub repository. The link of this code will be under the description, so you can just click on it and get access to the code. If you are new to this channel, make sure you subscribe because I release weekly videos on AI, machine learning, computer vision, and much more. Without much ado, let's get right into it. Alrighty, so as usual, let's go through the file system. What exactly will you need in order to complete this particular project? The first thing I'll talk about here is an API key. So you need to create .env file in this same working directory. And then you write API key, and in these two quotation marks, you have to paste in your API key here. In this tutorial, I'm using GPT 3.5 Turbo, but you can use any other large language model. All we need here is the API key. The next thing we'll look at here will be the requirement file. Which libraries do you need to install in order to follow this tutorial? So I've stored this in requirement.txt file for you guys. You can just do pip install. requirement.txt. Okay, so we'll be using I don't think we need Streamlit here. We'll be using Crewai and Crewai tools. So these particular libraries will allow us to utilize AI agents and large language model to perform web scraping. Okay, so just do pip install requirement.txt after cloning the repository, and this will go ahead and install these two libraries for you. So that's all with the files and the setup we need. Now let's get into the code. So at the very start here, we are importing all the necessary libraries. So you can see from Crewai, we are importing agent, tags, and crew. We use this agent to create AI agent for the tags you want to perform. Then we use the tags here to create tags for this particular AI agent. Okay. Alright, then from LangChain, we are also importing chat OpenAI, and this will help us to load our OpenAI model. In order to scrape data from the web, we are importing script website tool from Crewai tools. There are several tools that Crewai provides, so feel free because I'll put the link in the description where you can check these tools out. Then from there, we are just importing OS to get our API key, and also we are importing load.env from .env in order to load all environmental keys, in this case our API key. Alright. So first thing first, we need to bring in our API key and set up our model. So what we do here is that we do load.env, and then API key is called to os.getAPIKey, and in the .env file, this is the right name we use, API key. So once you do get.env and you put in this name, it's going to grab that API key from the .env file. All right, then we are saying okay, the model will be using GPT 3.5 Turbo. Okay, so I've signed up for that API key. You guys can also sign up for your API key. I think it's free for some time before you start paying. You have $5 free credits to use, so you can sign up for OpenAI API key and you can use it to perform these tasks. Alright, so right after declaring this model, I've now loaded this model, and all the parameters I need is the model, which I've said I'm going to use the 3.5 Turbo, and the API key here, which I'm specifying or getting it right here. All right. So now I can close here so that you guys can see the code well. And then the next thing to do is create a variable called site, and this will be the link to the particular website you want to scrape data from. Okay. So I'm using this particular website, which is IBM website. It's here. So I'm scraping the data on this particular site. So the link here is for that particular site. Alright, then the next thing is to instantiate the script website tool I've imported right here. So I've instantiated it, and all it takes is your website URL. Okay, so the URL to the website you want to script the data from. And fast forward, I've specified that here. So I'm just feeding in this URL as site. Let's get back to agents. If you have been following my channel, I've created a lot of tutorials about AI agents, how to combine AI agent system or multi-agent system. But in this particular tutorial, I'll be using only a single agent, okay? A single AI agent. And Right here, I said this agent is web scraper agent and is equal to the agent, an instance of the agent we've created. So with every agent you create, you have to give the agent role, and the role is what it will be doing. So in this case, I'm saying my role is that this agent is a web scraper. Then the goal, what is the goal this agent is going to achieve? So effectively scrape data on the website for your company. So it's scraping data for your company, okay? Then you give it a backstory. So the backstory is kind of explaining what the goal is, okay? So it's kind of explaining what the goal is. So the backstory I'm giving right here is you are expert web scraper. Your job is to scrape all the data for your company from a given website. So that's all, nothing fancy. Then after giving a backstory, I'm giving it a tools, okay? I'm giving this particular agent tools. And the tools are what this agent can work with. So these tools allow you to give this agent additional source of what? Information or additional source of data. Okay, so I'm giving it a web script tool because I've created an instance of it here. That, okay, this agent can go ahead and search the web using that particular web URL and get the data there, and then it will scrape this data for me. All right, so that's what I'm doing. That's what I'm specifying tools, and I'm giving it this particular tool. I said earlier, Crewai have many tools, and they also give you the advantage to create your own tool for your own use case. In future tutorials, I'll teach you guys how to create tools for agents yourself, okay? So this is a web scraping tool they've created already for you. All you need to provide is your what? Website link. Okay. So I'm giving this agent tool, and also I'm specifying verbose to be true so that when running this code, I can see whatever is going on at the back end. And over here, I'm specifying my large language model. LLM is equal to LLM because I've also instantiated the name here as LLM. So I'm just feeding it in that I should use this particular large language model to do the work. All right. Right after that, we know for every agent, you have to create a tax for that particular agent. So over here, I'm creating a tax, and I say web scraper tax is equal to tax. And inside tax, there are some couple of things you can specify. Description, and this describe what you want your agent to do. So scrape all the data on the site so your company can use it for decision making. Okay, so that's the description I'm giving it. You can feel free, give it a flexible decision. Okay, then the next parameter here is your expected output. What do you want this agent to give you? What's the output you want from this particular agent at the end of the day? So at the end of the day, what I want is all the content of that website, okay? So I'm scraping everything valuable on that website. That's what I want. And then I'm assigning the particular agent responsible for doing that. So here I said agent is equal to what? My web scraper agent. So my web scraper agent in this case is responsible for performing that particular task. All right, so this is another new thing I'm specifying here, output file. After doing the work, I need my data. So there is a parameter called output file, and this will output your data for you. And this is the name I'm giving it. So I'm giving it what? Data.txt. So this will save my data in a data.txt in the same directory I'm working in. And then I can go grab my data. All right. So after having my agent and my tax well defined, I can now create a crew. Okay, so crew help you to match this, your agents and your tax together. So you can assemble crew of agents together or crew of tax together. So over here in the crew, I've imported it at the top here called crew. So I just create an instance of that crew, and I've given it the agent, and our agent is our web scraper agent in a list form. The reason why it's in a list form is that you can assemble more agents together. So if you guys have been following, I've done tutorial where we use multi-agent system. You can check those tutorials out, okay? Then over here, we give it a tax. So the tax we have here is web scraper tax. So just give it this tax as well. And it can take small tax if you have many agents or many tax created. And over here, we specify verbose to be what? 2, okay? So in the crew, the verbose is between 1 and 2. So choosing the number between 1 and 2 will reveal much information about how this system is working when you are running the code. So you put it all the way out to 2 so that we can see everything clearly. The last thing is to kick these crews off. So it's like to run this crew so that they get started, they get doing their work. So we just say crew.kickoff and that's all. So we are saving whatever we are getting the result, and I'm also printing the results. Then even though I'm saving the data as data.txt from the output file, I'm also writing the result to a file called result.txt. I think this is not important though, but if you don't specify the output file, it will be a good thing to write it to a result.txt. So any of them works. So what I'll do now is to save this code and just run it. I'll clear this and rerun it once again so that we get a fresh terminal. So let me raise this up. And here we go, guys. So you can see it's scraping all the data from the website. So I need to read the content of the website in order to scrape all the data for my company. So that's the first task. That's the first thing it's trying to achieve. Then it went ahead, action read website content. So it has read all the content on that particular website. And you can see how long it is. All right. So it's not done yet. It's still running. So let's see what it will do next. And here we go. So right after doing that, you can see now here is the data from the website. So this is a particular data it has scraped from the website. It's very long. And it's printing it as well, because remember, we are printing this data. So it has done the job, and then it has printed every single data. So I think now we can clear this off. We can clear this off and look at where we are working. And right here, you can see we have our data.txt. So in the data.txt file, you can see it has saved all the vital information from that particular site. And this is a lot of information. Okay. So you can see how big this data is and how simple it is to just use these small lines of code to scrape data from web pages. Okay. In the result.txt file, it has also saved, I think, the same data. So guys, any of this works. Okay, any of this works. You can either save it as result.txt or use any of them. It will save it in your working directory for you. So just see the power of using large language models, using AI agents to scrape data instead of writing your own custom code, using requests, beautiful soup, and other Python libraries to achieve that. Okay, so you have to weigh the options, because for this one, there are some drawbacks as well. It's not every site that you can scrape the data from, because some sites have some data privacy. So with those sites, you can't scrape data. So that's like a bad side of this method. And even with traditional web scraping too, there are restrictions on certain sites. You can't scrape their data, I think so. So it's a disadvantage, but one way or the other is also good. Okay, so that's one thing. And the other thing is, if you want to, let's say, scrape more data or much data, which is greater than the context window of the large language model you are using, you can see that it will not be able, because the data is much than the input context the large language model can receive. So those are the things you have to know before trying to use this method. If in your case you don't need any of these things, will not be a trouble for you, you can just go ahead and use this method and scrape a lot of data for yourself. So all I have for you guys is happy web scraping, guys. If you love this tutorial, once again, give me a thumbs up, share with your network, and let's build a learning community together. Thanks for watching once again, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.